And Bishop there. Well, it's Thursday, so in a moment we'll be speaking to our musical guest, the band Ginger Safari, the Sydney-based group formed in 2010. They won the Triple J Unearthed competition that year. They've released two albums and have been described as not just a band, but a way of life. We'll ask them about that because of their involvement in the world music scene and their habit of visiting the places they sing about. Ginger Safari set off on a national tour next week. And joining us from the band are Joe and Marcus. Thanks very much for coming in. A way of life.
Thank you.
Are you sure?
I think that's what it says in your press guff.
Well, I think that's what our managers keep telling us.
Right,
it's okay. A way of life. Right. You got to commit to this.
But you are big travellers, and the name comes from the place where your grandmother lives.
Yes, she does. She moved there in the early 80s, I think, to kind of get involved with some AIDS patients and that sort of thing.
But we're talking about Uganda here.
We're talking about Uganda, yeah. She kind of, her marriage dissolved and she kind of left New Zealand, and it kind of, for me looking on, there's a lot of kind of mythology around our family history, and so that kind of was a great place to kind of start writing songs from. And that was about 3 years ago that we started writing this Ginger Safari project.
And Ginger is the name of the town. For anyone that's wondering,
yes, thank you
where
for
she lives.
That out.
Yes. Yeah. Okay.
And the last 18 months, you have travelled so much. I mean, is that crucial to the sound of the album? What kind of whereabouts in the world are we going to, you know, hear some in the album? How are we going to hear it?
There was the initial travelling before it was written, and you know, that was Marcus and Pepper going to Africa and India, and then as a band we. Went around, I don't know, you guys are still fine-tuning a lot of the songwriting that you know, is on the album. That was in New York and India and other places that we went as a group, as a band. So,
but because there's a lot of world music influence inside the band, it means that we're afforded the opportunity to play at a lot of different festivals around the world. So it means that we went to, like, we toured India with the band and the UK and Canada and the US. So a lot of this album is a reflection of the tours over last year and the year before.
You've got a lot of different instruments. You've got the call to prayer on there, I think. So, I mean, you've kind of picked stuff up as you've gone along. Is that how it works?
How did you know that was the call to prayer,
by the way? I've lived in the Arab world, so I kind of am familiar with that. But
that's how it ends, the album. There's like a loop at the very end, yeah.
It's now 2 years since your last album, is that correct?
Well, this is the first debut album. We had a couple of EPs before that.
And who gets to hear this one first? Where are we touring?
We start in Toowoomba, I believe.
I've got a list.
We're going up north anyway.
Sunshine Coast.
Right, you love it.
Next week, then Toowoomba, then Brisbane, then the Gold Coast. We've got to get out of it. We've got to get you to a break. The tour is coming up and Ginger Safari are going to perform for us a little later on. Do you want to go to do the throw to break for us, gents? Just follow the auto cue.
All right.
You go.
Victoria Murphy is here with all the sports news.
And maybe...
Thanks, Joe.
And after the break, West Coast Eagles coach John Wurtisford decide he's had enough after 12 years on the job.
We'll bring you all the sports news after the break.
Well done. Really nice to meet you guys.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.